Hi friends, welcome back. So if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit the subscribe button, click the bell icon to get notified of all the new videos as soon as we upload them. And after watching this video, if you like it, click the like button and share this video with your friends and family. So today we are watching an official trailer of the Age of AI. So Age of AI, I'm guessing it's Age of Artificial Intelligence. Wow. And it says this is YouTube Originals. So wow. Is YouTube also making movies or something?
Yeah.
Let me go ahead and find out what this is. Let's see. So it says, we are at the dawn of a new age and the implications of AI technology for humans are almost unimaginable. So that's true. And it says, welcome to the age of AI. Oh my God, this is getting interesting. And then it says, Robert Downey Jr. hosts a brand new YouTube original series, The Age of AI. Discover the most innovative and leading technologies that will change the world forever.
Yeah.
Wow. Technology is moving faster than ever and it's taking less time to be widely adopted. That's true. Join host Robert Downey Jr. to explore the depths of this fascinating, gripping technology. Oh, and it's episodes because it says you can watch all the episodes uninterrupted with YouTube Premium or watch episodes free with ads for a limited time.
Okay.
I hope they don't start charging in the middle of the episodes once we get into it and we want to know what happens in the end.
Maybe.
So guys, I mean, reading this, I am really interested in finding out exactly what this, series is about because the topic is very fascinating, artificial intelligence. So let's quickly go ahead and watch this trailer.
Technology. It's advancing faster and taking less time to be widely adopted than ever before.
Launch AI.
AI is basically an emulation of us.
They're a very special person to me.
Autonomous driving started.
AI can give us that answer that we've been seeking all along. Are we alone?
It's time to create a more powerful technology. We create a bigger lever for changing the world.
Artificial intelligence can help us to feed the world population.
AI is teaching the machine and the machine becoming smart.
All out of the realm of sci-fi and magic and now just science.
Right?
We're at the dawn of a new age. The age of AI.
So, wow, friends, this was really short, but very interesting, showing what are the possibilities and unlimitless, is the word right? Unlimited, I should say. So, unlimited possibilities with artificial intelligence. And when they showed that robot, the girl, which was actually a robot, I remember that we had done a reaction video on a robot teacher in India. Which whose, you know, outside look was not that good because they hadn't actually worked on the looks of that robot.
Yeah.
But looking at this, it was looking almost like a real human. And we've seen so many movies in which they're showing robots which are looking exactly like humans and they go ahead and act also as humans other than that they don't have feelings. But there are so many movies that have come and we used to think that this is just imagination. But as time is going by, passing by, it seems that nothing is impossible. Whatever you imagine, it can come true. So this was a fascinating, very short trailer. And it does say that it released in December. I'm really fascinated. So I would love to watch this. So after we are done with this video, guys, I'm going to search on YouTube and I'm going to go ahead and see exactly what this is and watch these episodes, how many they have, you know, gone ahead and released till now. So if you liked it, you can also watch it because it seems it's free on YouTube. So really, really beautiful, fascinating series that they have made. Wow.
Right. So it's a great thing that... Finally, we are seeing some applications of artificial intelligence. Now, we had done a video long time ago about in India there was a robot which was speaking things out, but that was not artificial intelligence, just a robot that does the repetitive things, like instead of a tape recorder that speaks, you put the tape recorder in a robot and the robot is just going to do a little bit and speak.
But it could also search through internet and get answers
a little bit. Yeah, that is just an algorithm like Google Assistant.
Yeah.
Google Assistants can also do the same thing.
Yeah.
But artificial
intelligence
is
way ahead.
Is more things where the machine learns some things on its own and change the algorithm, where it is advanced enough. For example, there are many technologies that are coming where, like, you know, you would say that it's all a program at this point, like the Tesla cars, there, if somebody comes in the front, it is just going to brake. When there's a autopilot going on, there may be a lot of obstructions, but it stops.
They it's showed that, to, right? They yeah, showed it, a self-driven stable, car.
It's able to maneuver and do all those things. But at some point, artificial intelligence is where the routine itself looks at a pattern and changes the way it acts. It looks at a pattern. If, for example, every day it's going, and after the red light, if it goes and there's one school children waiting to cross and to stop, then it will realize that that's going to happen every day. It will change its pattern and probably not take that road, take a different road next day. So, essentially they're enabling the machines to think on their own. Like humans based on the data. Mm-hmm. So it's obviously an algorithm, but looking at all the data patterns, it is able to see that and find out a way. And that way, I mean, many things will come. The first, I think most important will be, as they showed, that there are going to be domestic servants. There'll be like a robot.
I need that.
Right? Where at least in the countries where they believe that human beings as a servant is considered bad. Right? So in the US, there's no such concept of a domestic servant. Although there is a concept of maids, but it's not like the maids are living in the home. It's all driven out of, obviously, money, in the sense it's very costly to get that services. If you really want that services be super costly, it is better to do it yourself. So obviously, because the amount of labor is very less, it's like, you know, the population is not so high. And if every part of the citizen is educated, well educated, they would not like to do this kind of work. So that is why there's a basic thing. Education elevates everyone. Mm. You take everybody, for example, in India, and you give them superior education, the labor jobs will become less because they would not find that job interesting enough for themselves, for their cognitive abilities. They will say, no, this is a boring job, because now they are educated. So that is the same thing that is happening all over Europe and US, where the literacy rate is 100%, close to 100%. So now, and it is per law that you cannot stop anybody's education per law. So anyway, so at that point, you do need some kind of robots that can do simple things. Now, there are some robots that can clean up vacuums that are robotic. The vacuum, you start the vacuum, it will go, it will clean your whole house and go to a station, charge over there, and it'll keep doing stuff. And recently there was a news where, you know, that Roomba vacuum, that's the name of the model, that vacuum just started working in the night, and the couple were sleeping up, and they thought, oh my god, a thief has come. The ta-ta-ta was coming, what is going on? And they immediately called the police.
Oh.
And the police came, and when they troubleshoot, they said, oh, it's a vacuum. So the police was then took photos of the vacuum and everything, and they said, what the heck, man, in the middle of the night you're calling. And they were, a couple were saying, better safe than sorry. Okay, you know, we didn't realize that the Roomba is just going to start on its own. There was some malfunction. It had malfunctioned and started out of sequence. They were like, what is going on down?
Wow.
Or cut, is all going on. So the point is that artificial intelligence, domestic servants will come where they'll be programmed, where they can do the dishes, and
even
they can cook, do the sweeping,
and bring your
cook
food
and, yeah, food.
And stuff like
so
that.
As obviously they will be always, you know, attach on a software that, okay, do you want them to cook? Okay, here's this many dollars. Do you want them to do blah blah here? If do you want them to cook Indian cuisine, extra? So it's going to become like a business where
the
services,
more things you want in your robot, the costlier it's going to be.
And obviously some things are happening. I think the most exciting part today is the autonomous cars that Tesla is building. Mm-hmm. The ability where they say that it will go to such an extent that you will have all the cab companies will be driverless.
Mm-hmm.
Like Uber and all these things, they are going to go away. It will be very easy. If you want to go somewhere, you just click on your smartphone. A driverless car will come and park over there. It will beep and say, I'm ready. You sit in the car, you tell where it has to go, and it takes you there. Right? So basically, now with that, the drivers are going to go away. It'll be safe and it'll be secure because many times...
Movie along many, many years back. There was a movie, I think it was Arnold... his movie where he gets into a car, but the different... I think the car was not on the road, but I think it was flying. I could be wrong.
No,
but there was probably a movie... I mean, where they showed and we watched that movie when we were kids and we were like, wow, this is amazing. And we thought it was just imagination and we were like, wow, people are imagining such, you know, amazing things. And now it looks like a
possibility. Yeah, there were many such movies. Bruce Willis came one time as he was a taxi driver.
Yeah, I think either it was Bruce or it was Arnold. I don't remember. Maybe it was Bruce. But that movie was really awesome. And it's a really many, many years old movie. So guys, imagine.
So technology is coming very close, and I think artificial intelligence is whoever controls it. That was the other thing, that which country is the strongest in the world, and as they had said, the country that controls artificial intelligence and the space and the 5G or the cellular network. Why we say cellular network? Because everything is internet traffic. The faster traffic you are, the faster you can do the jobs. Now, all the artificial intelligent machines, they also need to be connected to something from which they can get help. So faster they can react, the better it is. Mm-hmm. And that's why 5G is pretty critical. Nowadays many people like use those landlines, and the internet is working through the landlines. Obviously in Europe and US that concept is going away. You just buy a small this much sized equipment and that is your internet. You just switch it on, put the battery, and it is working from your cell. So it is similar to hotspot on the phones, but the only benefit is that one is geared towards lot of connections that can be shared via that. Of course, today they are not that fast, but they're coming very close to the landline speeds. So maybe give it 10 years, I think the whole landline concept. Obviously, nowadays the landline phones are gone. Nobody,
we don't have
at least in the US, and nobody, or I would say maybe 1-2%, have a landline phone, but everybody only has a cell phone. The concept of landline is gone. And give it 10 more years, the concept of landline, even for internet, will go away, and you will have that just the small boxes. And obviously, the other innovation is the battery, because if you look at all the devices, the biggest constraint or the problem is a battery. You take your smartphone, and one day, after half a day, they are dead. And if your child likes to play video games, they'll be gone in 2 hours. The phone is zero. And you need to then carry backup battery and all that stuff. So I think that is the other innovation that is very quickly going to take place. So the battery will be very strong. And Tesla, obviously, is an electric car. So electric car is what? Charging battery. So it has a huge battery pack. And they are also innovating very quickly. And they are trying to make such powerful batteries that can run for long. Because now on single charge, I think Tesla's maximum capacity is 364 or something like that. Miles. 364 something miles in one charge. And if the battery technology goes better, obviously they will benefit hugely. So there's a lot of research that is going on. So all the, people say what kind of engineer you want to be. So one option is chemical engineers, because nowadays chemical engineers that are doing research on batteries, they're in huge demand just because of these electric cars, because of smartphones. Everything needs to have a strong battery because people are mobile. So that is another, stream that is gaining some importance compared to other streams. Of course, artificial intelligence and machine learning is also very hot nowadays because technology is going in that direction.
Yes, guys. So this was an amazing video. Really, really had enjoyed it. It was, I think, hardly a minute long, but very, very interesting. So we are going to go ahead and search for the episodes of this series. And if you found it fascinating too, you can definitely also watch it on YouTube. So, okay, friends, we'll take our leave and we'll come back again in another video very soon. Till then, take care and bye-bye.
Oh, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon so it notifies you when I put in my new video for you to enjoy. Bye!